Hey guys, it's Adam Gusso coming to you from Modern Blues Harmonica. I want to talk today about using the high end of the harp. And I want to talk just really about one particular way. What I want to talk is just a basic idea that'll kind of help you unpack the high end of the harp. And this basic idea is to take what you know on the lower end of the harp and to transfer it to the upper end. And so let's start with the most basic possible lick, which is I want to play the tonic note. One question I would ask any beginning harmonica player, or let's say intermediate harmonica player, is, so if I want to play the G note on a C harp, I'm playing cross harp on a C harp, where are all the tonic notes? Where are all those G's? And most people will say, well, two draw. They might quickly remember that the three blow is the same. Hopefully they say six blow. And really, you're not an intermediate player until you remember that the nine blow is the same note. So you've got four G's. Two draw, three blow, six blow, and nine blow. Okay. But let's forget about the three blow for the time being. Let's just use the two draw, the six blow, and the nine blow. So a basic riff might be, let's say I want to do what we call the major triad. The oh, say, can you see? Where are those notes in the lower octave? Four draw, three draw, two draw. It's really easy for you. And you'd go up to the six blow. So you might practice that. And that's actually good practice because it makes you jump from the four draw up to the six blow. And those kind of jumps are things harp players don't naturally do very well. So it's good to practice them. And you should have no trouble jumping from the four draw to the six blow and finding the six blow. Right. Let's say I want to move that up an octave. So I want the equivalence to the four draw, three draw, two draw. Starting, well, where? Let's say I want to go up. So I'm going to do the equivalent of like Rock Around the Clock. Da-da-da-da-da-da, root, third, fifth. Let's start on the sixth blow. Now here's what's interesting. If I go, well, it's sixth blow. But so you might say, well, is it sixth blow, seventh blow, eighth blow? No, it's definitely not that. So what it is it's six blow, seven draw, eight draw. The interesting thing about that is that it's very close to the conditioned muscle memory stuff you're doing the first in the lower octave, which is to say, I'm playing a note, then I'm moving over one to the right and playing the same, playing a note in the same direction and moving over one to the right and playing a note in the same direction. That would be two draw, three draw, four draw. Pretty easy to remember. What's interesting is you start on the sixth blow, then you actually have to change direction. But you move over to the one to the right, change direction, then you move over one to the right and keep the same direction. It's 75% the same as it is in the first octave. You just start on the sixth blow. That's, to me, that's like, if you get how important it is that what you've just done is take a lick that you know in the lower octave, move it to the upper octave, and you've leveraged the muscle memory that you have in the lower octave to the upper octave, and most of it is available. You're leveraging. So you're not, it's not like it's brand new, nor is it exactly the same. And what's amazing is so many harp players are incredible wimps, and they stay away from the upper end because stuff's just not kind of organized exactly the same. And there's even people who invent new kinds of harmonicas that have, so that you can just sort of play the same as you'd play another. No, just expend a little bit of effort to create slightly new, to sort of adjunct muscle memory is what I would say. But remember, you can kind of keep the same. So let's go down. If we're going to go 4-3-2 draw, let's start from the 8 draw. 8 draw, 7 draw, 8 draw, 7 draw, 6 blow. And then what? 9 blow. Same as six blow. You jump two from, well, wait a minute. Ah. You don't jump two and blow. You only jump up one and blow. So the difference between the atro and the nine blow, that's a interval of a fourth from the fifth up to the octave. It's only one hole, whereas from the four draw to the six blow is two holes. So there's another point where you've got to adjust. But you're still going from a draw hole up one or two holes to a blow hole, which is the octave. Again, you see what we're doing here? We're just, it's like get your foot in the door for that upper octave and just leverage what you know. I don't know why so many blues harmonica players just, including Little Walter, who doesn't go up there. Big Walter goes up there a little bit. Junior Wells, nah. And nobody really seems to want to play melodically except a few of the greats, like Paul DeLay, who's wonderfully melodic up there, because he figured all this out, Sugar Blue. So what I've just shown you how to do is how to leverage. Okay, let's try something else. Well, that's Mary Had a Little Lamb. That's actually easier to play in the upper octave than it is in that octave. So there I'm, three draw, bend it down a whole step, and go back up. What would it be? Can you find it in the upper octave? Start on the seven draw. Can you do it? Actually much easier to do than it is. I mean, for unless you're good, I suppose, and then it's not that hard to do either place. So there's no draw involved. Muscle memory. Muscle memory is that both of the notes are draw notes. But of course, the two draw is different than the six blow, so you're changing directions. Anyway, what's another example of this? Okay, how about this? How about the boogie woogie line? So I'm going two draw, three draw, four draw to six blow, excuse me, to five blow. And then five draw. So it's actually root, third, fifth, sixth, flat seventh. And then back down. Boogie woogie line up above. But now what's interesting is, that's definitely a little trickier. What are the notes? Six blow, seven draw, eight draw. This sixth, which you play on the five, when I say sixth, I mean the melodic interval, the scale degree of the sixth, which is a sort of sweet note. It's the five blow on the lower octave, it's the eight blow on the upper octave, but in both cases it's a blow. So the muscle memory there is, oh, if I want that kind of sweet sound, I'm gonna go to a blow note. Playing cross arp. And then if I want to go up to the octave, it's just slide over. Just slide over one and blow. Keep blowing from the sixth up to the octave above. Interesting. I'm going to end the lesson with this. I just wanted a quick hit kind of thing on the upper octave. That flat seventh, which you have in the middle of the harp, it's the five draw, if you're going up from two draw up to five draw. This actually very much tracks blues singing in melodic terms. Little Walter has a song where he goes up that way. The Beatles actually have a song, I think. Love Me Do? me do? Well, that's the 5 draw. Slide up to the 9 draw, and you've got that flat 7th, that sort of high hard one, that high curvy bluesy whoa. And I think one of the great underutilized melodic areas on the harmonica would be singing kind of vocalizations on the upper octave, would be playing harmonica in a way that you're tracking vocalizations. Let me show you what I mean. And I'm going to use the mic and harp and amp, and I'm going to put on a little bit of delay. So I'm going whoa, whoa. Well, I don't know. Well, I don't know what to say. You know, my baby doesn't love me anymore. You know. Oh, 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 oh. Actually, just even bad blues singing connected with harmonica playing, you can leverage the two. I can learn how to sing. Whoa, 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 whoa. Pretty bad, man, pretty bad. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'm gonna cut this part of the lesson out. Outtake. Guys, that's all for now. It's all for now, but I will come back at you with some more lessons in the not too distant future. I promise. See you down the road. Bye-bye.